Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I thank the Honourable Member for the question. I would like to wish all students, including our students in chambers today, a very good first day at school for the second term, and I wish you well for the second term. The Ministry, Honourable Speaker, administers services and programs aimed at ensuring that senior citizens in Fiji are supported to lead a life of dignity. And this includes providing care for the elderly residents at our three golden age homes across the country located in Suva, Lotoka, and Lambasa. Just as a brief background, the structural condition of the more than 80 years old golden age in Lotoka has deteriorated significantly and is in urgent need of repair. In light of the above, it was decided that the Mbaa Mission Hospital be renovated to temporarily accommodate the residents and carers while the ministry renovates the age-old property. And to this end, the grant of $710,801 was allocated this financial year for the renovation of the Mbaa Mission Hospital. However, Honourable Speaker, and for the information of members, the beginning of this financial year, the ministry was advised by the Methodist Church of Fiji, who are the owners of the Mbaa Mission Hospital, that there were alternate plans for the property. So due to time constraints and the urgency of the project, the ministry, with the assistance of the provincial administrator in Mbaa, worked on identifying an alternative site. Please note we've explored other alternatives referred by the board chair of the home, and unfortunately, those sites were neither available nor suitable for the residents. Honourable Speaker, the ministry through PA Mbaa now has managed to secure an alternative property and will be moving the residents and carers to Matanakilangi House, which is owned by Mbaa Provincial Holding Company Limited. And we'd like to thank Mbaa Provincial Holding Company Limited for this partnership. The ministry has signed this letting agreement from the 30th of April of this year. Matanakilangi House needs to be renovated to meet the needs to accommodate our elderly. The renovation works will be undertaken by the Divisional Engineer West under the Ministry of Public Works at a cost of $341,835. The Ministry of Finance has approved the diversion of the fund from its initial intention, which was the renovation of the Mbaa Mission Hospital, to the renovation of Matanakilangi House. At present, the ministry awaits the request to incur the expenditure under RIE for the release of funds to the Divisional Engineer West, who has advised that the refurbishment of Matanakilangi House will take about 8 weeks. Once Matanakilangi House is refurbished, the residents and carers will then be moved to allow for works on the restructure of the current site to take place. And on that note, I'd also like to confirm to this House that consultations are also underway for the restructure of the Golden Age Home in Lotoka. Honourable Speaker, as I conclude my response, I'd like to extend my heartfelt gratitude and appreciation to the dedicated members of the Board of Visitors for the Golden Age Homes. Their unwavering commitment and tireless efforts in ensuring the well-being and care of our elderly residents do not go unnoticed. A special thanks to Mr. Kanti Punja, Mr. Abhinesh Chand, Mrs. Rajneesh Charan, Mr. Vinesh Chandra, Mrs. Yvonne Langilevu, Mr. Selwanand, Ms. Shivali Kashyap, and Ms. Maritha Rokovanda Halasi, and Mr. Rajesh Patel for their outstanding leadership and service. Your invaluable contributions are truly commendable and have made a significant difference in the lives of our senior citizens. Thank you for your dedication and commitment to our Golden Age homes. Thank you, Honourable Speaker.